I'm back. Well, sort of.
And with a little bit of a cold, but we have to do this. Well, lately I have been publishing videos on this channel without my face on, but today I decided to do something different, and hello, here I am, I'm showing my face. So I decided to do this video to talk about something that has been a hot topic here on this platform, and it is quitting YouTube. Saying bye, adios, ciao to the red play button platform. We've seen creators, even science communicators like Tom Scott, say they need a break from YouTube. I can relate to a lot of those creators. So my goal with this video is to weigh in on this topic as a medical science creator slash educator. You have probably watched many videos about this topic, people saying that they are tired of the algorithm or that they feel pressure to put out new content every week. We see people talking about going through burnout. Some are creatively exhausted. Coming up with ideas to keep people engaged with you is not easy. 13 years ago, when I started doing what I do now on YouTube, there were only cat videos and people pranking their grandmothers. So now we're here, it's 2024. The platform is quite crowded, as the latest statistics, around 3.7 million new videos are uploaded to YouTube every day. Yeah, 3.7 million videos. So coming up with ways to get your video to be noticed is not easy. Now, if you search for a topic like anatomy of the humerus, you find hundreds of videos. To rank on this search and to be seen, it's almost mission impossible. When I publish a video on this channel, it usually doesn't get many views. In time, we see that can change and videos get traction and visibility, but it's definitely harder to be noticed now. With all of that, quitting has also become an option for me, believe me, or at least taking a break. But should I be doing that? Well, to answer that question, I first need to discuss a couple of points. Firstly, let's talk about YouTube as a platform for medical or science educators. YouTube has been a cornerstone for educational content, without a doubt, offering a unique space where complex topics can be broken down visually. For medical educators, this is invaluable. The ability to demonstrate procedures, explain intricate concepts, and provide real-life case studies offers an unparalleled learning experience. But is it still the right platform to post medical or scientific content, especially now with the evolving digital landscape? As I mentioned before, one concern that has been arising is the sheer volume of content on YouTube, without a doubt. With millions of videos uploaded daily, there is a valid concern about whether our educational content can still find its audience. Is the platform overpopulated, especially with science content? While there's an abundance of information, I believe that quality and specificity stand out. There is always demand for accurate, reliable medical information, without a doubt. And if you can provide that, well, there is a space for you on YouTube. I've seen when we put effort into a certain video, we work hard on a script, we spend time creating fun animations, we create a thumbnail that stands out. I've noticed that even though those videos don't get a lot of views in the beginning on this channel, they tend to rank high in time. People notice them. People want quality and the algorithm just follows. That's all beautiful and all, but it creates an issue. And I'm talking about pressure to produce high quality content consistently to keep up with the YouTube algorithm. This is a reality for many of us. The algorithm favors regular, engaging content. For medical science educators, this can be a bit daunting. Creating content that's both informative and compliant with scientific standards takes time and effort, believe me. However, this should be balanced with the commitment to provide valuable, accurate information. Not to mention that some of us work two jobs. Yes. And video production is time consuming. So to balance that out is not easy at all. People who work in this field know that there is a lot of love when it comes to producing videos and sharing them with the world, right? So what's my stance? Well, despite challenges, I plan to stay on YouTube, and here's why. I genuinely love YouTube and the community that we've built here. It's a platform that allows for creative freedom and has a vast reach that can't be easily replicated elsewhere. Not to mention the fact that I have so much fun every time I publish a video. True, even though it takes a lot of work, getting feedback from this community means the world and helps me grow as a medical science communicator slash educator. YouTube remains the strongest platform for long-form content, without a doubt. Basically allow us to dive deep into topics, something that's crucial for medical science education. Short-form content is fun, and I still use it to do quick reviews or answer some questions, but long-form is still the format I stand behind. So sue me, please don't. YouTube is still the best platform to publish evergreen videos. And by evergreen, I mean those videos that you publish today, and a few years later, they are still getting views. Unlike other social media platforms that if you publish something now, it might be popular for a few days, and then poof, gone. YouTube is just the second large search engine in the world, not to mention that it is part of Google. So when you publish something in the platform, it has the possibility to appear on many search queries. While the platform and its algorithms evolve, so can we. Adapting our content and strategies ensures we continue to engage our audience effectively. I learn new things every day. How I can engage with my audience, what you guys like and dislike. This helps me become a better communicator. Finally, and I guess most important reason why I decided to continue doing what I do here on YouTube is that I love the journey. I know. Beautiful. Kumbaya. Yes, I do have some goals for this channel and for a lot of things I do in life. But most important thing is that I enjoy the process of getting there. I love creating these videos. I love seeing the reactions, the community we have built. Loving the journey doesn't mean I cannot stop and take a break to sip a coffee and enjoy the view. I won't be taking one break now, but as long as I am enjoying what I am doing, I will be around. Either here on this channel or at KenHub. So yeah, while there are valid concerns and challenges, the mission to educate and the love for the platform keep me anchored here. I guess the path of education is as much about learning and adapting as it is about teaching. And to my fellow educators and creators, remember why you started. Take a break if you need one, and only create YouTube content if you have fun doing it. Yes, it's work, but if it's painful, something needs to change. Okay, so thank you very much for being here on this venting session. If you're grappling with similar questions or have insights to share, let's start a conversation in the comments below. I really want to hear what you have to say about all of this. And of course, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content. Until next time, keep learning and stay curious.